Weekly update time. And the director of cross country at South Dakota State, the one and only Rod DeHaven, joins us. And a lot to recap from this past week. First off, Coach, how are you?
I'm doing wonderful. Thank you. You know, we're, 14 days from Hobo Day? Or not, no, 14. We're down to, 10 or whatever? I don't know. I'm a math minor. You tell me.
I think it's actually 11.
11. Goes to 11.
This one goes to 11.
Really?
As a matter of fact, it does.
11.
11.
Excellent.
Which means?
11 days of the conference meet as well.
I was just going to say, it's right. One and the same.
Right. But you cannot compare the two, clearly.
Well, there'll be...
Apples and oranges.
Apples and oranges, but not carrots.
No. No.
Well, you were in Stillwater, Oklahoma with part of the Jackrabbit team. We talked about this last week. Sent a bunch of women and some men to Bradley in Peoria, Illinois, but some of the men went down to Stillwater, Oklahoma, and quite a performance there. We talked about how big of a meet that would be and all the competition, and you finished sixth as a team. What'd you see from your squad in Stillwater, Oklahoma?
Obviously, I think we saw a lot of fight, a lot of spirit, and the ability, I guess, for this group to kind of run as a team probably for the first time all fall. Some of that comes to finally conditioning, being ready for a race like that maybe we weren't ready for, at GRIAC. And understanding that, particularly for some of those fifth-year guys, that this is, it's kind of now or never. And, sometimes that situation does not always play out well. And, the day they were aggressive and on a course that probably doesn't reward aggressive running as well as other courses might reward. It was, a very hearty effort that, when you look back on it 5-10 years from now, I'm sure it's something we're probably going to talk about because it's one race. It won't mean anything in 2 weeks, unless we capitalize on it. But when you look at, the field, and it did kind of diminish, I think there was, some chatter that, okay, this was maybe not the greatest pre-national race of all time. Granted, yes, I think geography and, just being in the middle of the country and maybe not a super easy place to get to. But, for us, it's just an opportunity. And that's, I think when you're in a mid-major, cross-country program, you just want an opportunity, especially when you feel like you've got a lot of horses in the shed that can get after it. And the young men did. And when you look at the list of teams, I think going into the meet, one of the big things was Wyoming beat us pretty handily at GRIAC, and was like, well, how that'll be a measuring stick. How close can we get to Wyoming? Have we gotten better? And to turn around and beat Wyoming. And I don't know if they had a good day, bad day. I'm assuming that their coaching staff's not, doing cartwheels at South Dakota State, beat them. But for us, it was like, okay, that was during the race. That was literally something I could yell at the guys, with the timing system. You can figure out, okay, we're 40 points down at 5K and look like we're closing. And, a remarkable last K from the men. They knocked off another 30 points, get Wyoming, fall 7 short of UCLA. So that was big, but then we look at the list of schools behind us, schools that, within our region that were ranked. So you've got your Iowa, Missouri, Kansas State, I think Kansas State was ranked behind us, but we get all those schools. We get Purdue, we get Washington State, we get Nebraska. So basically we get 75% of the old Big Eight in one day. Missouri, Pittsburgh, it was, for those guys, it was fun because, when you're a mid-major, you don't look like those schools. And, these guys, we've been to Oklahoma State twice and had a similar result back in the 2019 regional where, again, it makes no sense. A team in, relatively flat Brookings, South Dakota can run exceptionally well on a very hilly and challenging course. So, hopefully it's a good omen. Hopefully it's a catalyst for what's to come. I know the young men are excited about it, deservedly so. And, I think there's a potential that group can run a little bit better. Max Selbach, who was our sixth guy on Saturday, probably, still some effects of long kind of COVID that kind of bug him, but, good run for him. Josh Becker, tremendous run, fourth year from Eau Claire, Wisconsin, great run for him. And Daniel Burkhalter, all the way down the line. Ben Olson continues to be just rock solid, and that was great. Tom Brookman had an incredible last K. Joseph Minor-Williams, you know, just went out and said, hey, I'm going for it, and whatever happens, happens. I mean, the guy's in third place, I think, at, you know, a certain point in the race. And, you know, that was fun, you know, to be in that environment, have those guys execute. And, you know, not, obviously not an easy trip, but it was well done.
Well, certainly a good jumping point for the Summit League Championships and a Big 8 reference as well. So kudos to you for that.
Who doesn't love the old Big 8?
Doesn't love the Big 8. I did not see that coming, I'll be honest. Mm-hmm. All right.
It's a Tuesday.
It certainly is, because we're 11 days from Hobo Day and the Summit League Championships.
Yeah. Exactly.
This one goes to 11.
Mm-hmm.
And if you get that reference, then come on board. We got plenty more where that came from the rest of the year. The rest of the men and the women spent time in Peoria, Illinois on Friday and Saturday. So give us the rundown of how they performed at Bradley.
You know, I think when you look at the Bradley results, particularly on the women's side, you know, we're measuring that group, you know, how are we going to stack up with the rest of the conference, in particular North Dakota State and UND at that meet. And, you know, the times look great. And I think when you look, you know, Aaliyah Hansen, Maya Kaiser, Caitlin Bright, Nicole Greer, you know, all really solid runs. Nicole got off a little slow and weaved her way through a plethora of runners to get, you know, up to where she got. I think the one thing that, you know, we just need to be better about is the aggressiveness of that next group. And, you know, some of it was, you know, somebody coming off sickness and maybe not feeling as good as what they normally would. But we've got to solve the riddle of, you know, can we get a fifth closer to Nicole? Because we can't, then, you know, it's going to be a fairly easy competition for North Dakota State, who's, you know, running well and, you know, good program. And, you know, that's what we're chasing right now. You know, and conference meets, you know, are different types of races. You won't have 38 teams in there. So it'll have a different feel. You'll be able to pick out, you know, where am I supposed to be, you know, who's where and all that kind of stuff. And, you know, we just got to figure out a way to get a little bit better, a little bit more aggressive here in the next 11 days.
Again, rumor has it we're 11 days away, but
right.
No competition this weekend. So between now and the Summit League Championships, what is the plan? What's the outlook for Jack?
Right. Well, I think the first thing, you know, obviously coming off trips like that, you have to be smart about, you know, recovery and then, you know, try and instill confidence. You know, you're not probably going to move the needle physically too much at this point. You're just trying to cook up ways to, you know, kind of fine-tune things, but you're not really going to change fitness too much. So we probably are what we are, but, you know, can we be a better version of that at this point? And, you know, it's conference meets are extremely fun in the fact that obviously the importance of that one day, you know, unlike, you know, the team sports of a regular season and, you know, the head-to-head competition, this is the one time that, you know, a lot of people are going to take notice of, okay, what are the results of the Summit League meet? You know, who cares how many times you beat somebody during the regular season? And that's important, you know, for our men to note as well, that a conference meet is going to feel a little bit different. Obviously, a big target on our back in North Dakota State, running very, very well, and cannot take them lightly, and we need to stay humble, to have an edge to us the rest of the way, and be ready to fight when we get to Grand Forks.